Some might argue, but my job as a content creator is not to use the biggest word possible. My job as a content creator is to use the right word. And sometimes that right word is... Welcome back, ladies and gentlefolk. Today, we're going to make a tier list of obscure Victorian insults. From the beginning of time, insults exist. From the Roman bathhouses, where graffitis were very much in vogue, to Shakespeare, who said, "Villain, I have done thy mother," and was the master of dick jokes and innuendos. We have the plethora of words that we can use for our friends or foes in our fit of passion. Language is an ever-evolving entity. Sometimes people try to sanitize it, like giving out whole list of words to be banned, which I do not agree.
I will very willingly offer you this.
I managed to put my hand on this little piece of culture here. My little friend, the Dictionary of the Vulgar Tongue, Dictionary of Puckish Slang, University Wits, and Pickpocket Eloquence. So today we're going to tier list some of these very obscure ad hominem insults and see how would we react at this time if we on the street, for example, being called a chit? Tier list, please. Thank you. Oh, that's a nice one. It says thornback. According to this book, it's an old maid. And some other sources say that it's an unmarried woman after 30. I don't know. I don't feel like it's necessarily insulting. Of course it's meant to be insulting, because women not married after a certain time are a liability to society at this era, but no, it's fine. A wagtail. That, of course, it just kind of denotes that the people are down to party, but no, I would totally love it. And according to some other sources, it could be used both for men and women, so it's even non-gendered. Oh, and it's a nice one here, it's called Tatter de Mullion. It sounds like it has some French origins. A ragged fellow whose clothes hang in all tatters. I don't know, it's kind of too long to be an actual insult. Insults are usually very short to throw at people. It's more like, nah, it's alright. If somebody calls me a Tatar de Mullion, I would probably know that person is a well-mannered person and trying its best to find some way to make me hurt. But alas, gib face. This is given to people with protruding lower lips, like a horse face. Gib face. I wouldn't like that. I really wouldn't like that. It sounds nasty. It sounds absolutely nasty. Of course, I just recently made a whole family who is famous about being a gib face. But no, I don't like it. Shabaroon. It more sounds like a dessert than an insult. An ill-dressed shabby fellow. Well, it's not as weak as Dr. Demolion, but nah, it's a no-no for me. It's an absolute no-no for me. Smell fungus. A fault finder. A fault finder who is looking for problems, especially aimed for travelers who came back from wild foreign countries and then, oh, I'm sorry, Louis, and then complain about the state of things. Literally, a Victorian Karen. Well, small fungus, just like my gynecologist, looks for problem where people look for enjoyment. A rake. Or a rake hell, or rake shame, or rake fire. A debauched fellow. Okay, I have some personal feelings here. Being called a rake probably sounded like a very, very, very harsh insult in Georgian times. But no, no, fam, it's... I would totally call my cat a rake. Ragamuffin. A ragged fellow, one all in tatters, a tatterdemalion. If somebody would call me a muffin on the street, I would probably roll in the dirt from laughter. I'm not gonna lie. Ragamuffin! Okay, I think I lost the plot. Okay, that's a lobcock is the next. Is like it's a name for a dull, inanimate fellow, somebody who just lies like that's all right. Also a nah, it's okay. It's fine. It's meh. Hoity-toity. A hoity-toity wench, a giddy, thoughtless, romping girl. Okay, this is specifically aimed for young people and young ladies. So I would take it as a no-no, also. I wouldn't like it. But I wouldn't step for it. Hobber de hoy. Half a man and half a boy. A lad between both. A teenager, technically. Yeah, that's an okay one. It's a mild one. It's nice. The word is Golumpus. Pronounce it right, Golumpus. A large clumsy fellow. Like the ones that look like a scarecrow run away from a nearby field. Okay. That's absolutely an ass tier. I can totally call my dog a Golumpus. A fop doodle. A stupid person who makes bad decisions, a fop doodle. That goes up, way, way, way up. In another resource, it's also used for people who has a problem of... But that's kind of a theme here. Poodle faker! Rather surprisingly, this is not a word for people who dress up as animals. It's a newly commissioned officer frequenting in ladies' company. And other sources also say that, yes, a dude who spends too much time with girls, in more like as a ladies' man than a queer person. Yeah, poodle faker. It's rather a clumsy attempt to label someone as a person who is not at the right place for the station. Meh. Dolly mop. A part-time or amateur prostitute. A lady who dabbled into the service industry. On this channel we have full respect for everybody who works in the industry. Ladies, boys, boy ladies, lady boys, everybody. Full respect. But Dolly mop is... I would not like it. There is a plethora of words in this very illustrious book that you can use for people from the industry, but Dolly mop is not one of them I would really like. So it's a... don't do that. Bracket-faced. It just means ugly. Nah, I don't like it really, but it's a very mild one compared to other profanities we just heard before. Blunderbuss. A short gun with a wild boar for carrying slugs. Also a stupid blundering fellow. Just to spice up the thing here, blunderbuss is actually a Dutch word. And I have seen a blunderbuss in the Rijksmuseum before. It's very famous about not being really precise. It's just spewing slugs. And if it hits something, yeah, that's cool, but it's not really a useful thing. Anyway, there is a blows or a blowsabella. Oh, that's cute! That's actually cute. A woman whose hair is disheveled or hanging around her face, or a slattern. Which I am not. But I think it's a very adorable word. It's cute. Oh well. That's it for today, my dear fellows. Thank you for coming in with me on this adventure because, well, it was fun. As a closing thought, please don't insult people.
Until it's absolutely necessary.
Until it's absolutely necessary. Behold my church window of profanity. Look at this fella having fun here.